and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to go over trap soul and how to achieve that modern R&B sound mixed with the hip-hop influence. So this sound really comes down to treating the 808 as if it were a real bass guitar. You know, with real bass guitars, you can do pitch bends, you can do hammer-ons, whatever you want to call the term. It's where the pitch bends from one note to the next. And we can program that in using different MIDI slide notes and different things. So we'll go over bass slides. We're going to go over how to reverse your pads and how to get that kind of Drake-ish sound by reversing the pad, and how to keep it musical as well, because sometimes when you reverse, it's not as musical as you'd think. And then we're going to get into just how to create the drums. So it's basically three parts. So let's start with our pad, because that creates the chord structure for the song. Now you can open up any pad you like. I'm going to open up Nexus, and I'm going to go to Epic Pads. And let's look for something that has a lot of motion to it. Not a gated pad. We're talking about something that has like shimmer sounds in it or something. I don't know. I'm going to click on random stuff here and play the pad. Now, I should have picked Chimes in Space. That sounds like it's a better match. Actually, this one has what I want. Okay, so great. Now we just need to play the right chords. There are many different chords you could play, but let's start off with ninth chords. I'm going to use the chord progression from our other video, how to make an R&B chord progression, so that you can see how it's applied. So let's see here. We're going to start with F minor 9. I'm going to not rush through it, but I'm not going to define everything we're doing, because again, we have a different video going over how to create this chord progression. So let's start here at F. And let me make sure snap to grid's on. So let's start out at F. And let's build out the F minor 9 chord. So the minor 9 chord code is 0, 3, 7, 10, 14. If you don't know what those are, you go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. We have free videos going over chord codes and much more music theory for free. So we're starting at F. We're going to use our chord codes to create the F minor 9th chord. So we're at 0. We're just counting up the keyboard. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, so that's pretty simple. Now what I'm going to do is raise the top part of the chord up an octave. And I'm going to create a bass octave for the root note. So F in 2 octaves lower, and then the main portion of the chord is in a higher octave. So let me raise this up an octave so we can get a better... Okay, so let's right-click the tempo. Let's start tapping it up. We're at about 97, 100 BPM. So the way to get the trap sound is to produce your drums in double time, so where the tempo is actually higher than the perceived BPM. And we do that because we can create easier glitch notes. And now we're going to go to G sharp major 9. So again, we're referencing the chords we went over in the R&B chord progression video. Let's see here, G sharp. So we're going to build out the major 9th chord code, which is different from the minor 9th chord code. So we're going to 0, 4, 7, 11, 14. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And again, do the same type of thing. Raise up the top portion of the chord, and then duplicate your root note into an octave lower. Now this has a very long release for this pad. So to counteract conflict between frequencies, I'm going to lower the release for this sound, so it cuts off when we let the note go, and it doesn't have that excess release tail. And now let's go to D sharp major 9. Now I'm just going to keep it to these three chords. I'm not going to create a super complex chord progression, but let's go to D sharp, and let's add a D sharp up here. So D sharp major 9, we're going to use the same chord code, or you could just copy this chord code and just transpose it down to D sharp. It's the same chord. Okay, so chord codes will always be that chord no matter what. Let's see what the tempo says. So that's what the pad sounds like. Now what we're going to actually do here is record the pad into Edison. Okay, so let's open up Edison in the mixer track one. So make sure your pad is going to a mixer track, and we're going to record the MIDI into audio. So I like to go to the playlist when I do this, and I like to separate patterns so it leaves a nice gap. Okay, so let's go to song mode, and that's important because when it repeats itself, it's harder to chop the audio. Let's go to Edison, hit record on input. So it has a nice release tail to it, a reverb tail. And that's why I like to separate it from the other patterns. If I didn't separate it, it would just repeat itself and it would overlap the reverb, so you wouldn't get that tail. And you could always use the tail for different things. But let's zoom in. Let's just make sure we're grabbing the very beginning of the sound. And we can drag this straight into the playlist or drag it into a sampler. I'm going to drag it into the playlist. So now I can get rid of the MIDI. We don't really need it unless we need to go back and do something. So now I just need to make sure it's on tempo. So now what I'm going to do is slice this, get rid of the excess. Okay. And you could make it unique, or you could just open it back up. It's going to make it unique, so it's different from the first sample. Okay. And we're going to go to this new sample, and I'm going to reverse it. So now it's reversed. But the thing is, the tail is harder to line up the tail. So what I like to do is go to snap to grid, go to a very small unit, try to line it up with it, treat it like it's almost like we're doing this backwards. So now I want this portion to be lined up, and we can get rid of the excess easier. So now let's go to snap to grid none and really zoom in and line this up with the grid here. So it looks like it lines up right there. So at that point, let's zoom back out, and all we have to do here is go back to bar mode and slice out the excess beginning in the tail. So you can count out four bars, or you could do whatever you want here. I'm just going to create a four bar section here. So now this is the reversed audio. Okay. And it's perfectly timed to the grid. So let's send that to the mixer, send that to track one. Now we have a very unique sound, you know, something that you wouldn't get by playing an instrument regularly. That reverse sound is very unique. Now, this is a very bright sound, meaning it has a lot of high frequencies in it. So you can always add filtering or different effects to it. I'm going to add just a slight low pass filter because it's super bright of a sound. Let's pull down the volume so it doesn't overtake the whole track. So there's half the battle, is just finding out how to reverse the audio properly to your playlist. Now let's add an 808. So again, you got to remember, even if you reference your chord progression, it's working backwards. So you have to realize that the first chord is actually the D sharp chord. The second chord is G sharp. The third chord is F. So you have to think of it that way musically. Okay. So now let's go into our browser. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's load up an 808 we can use to create a nice bass line. Now I'm doing the 808 now because, you know, musically we're already done. The vocalist is going to add the melody. So let's add the bass line here with 808 Science drums. Let's pick out a nice smooth 808. 808 Carbon always works for the smooth tone. Let's right click, open that up. Now again, we have another video on how to tune your 808s. I'm not going to get into that because it takes too much time. Let's go to envelope and we're going to right click. Tune this to A because this 808 actually is in the key of A. So that's, we have to tune the 808 first so that when we play musical notes, it actually makes sense. Let's go to our playlist. Now let's add in a bass line, which works along with that chord progression. So remember, the chord progression is backwards. It's not forward. So we're not starting on F. We're starting on D sharp or wherever we were, D sharp. So if you really feel like you're confused, you can always copy the chord progression, paste it into the new pattern. Let's see here. And you can go to your piano roll, switch it to the Nexus. And in FL Studio, they have a tool called Flip. You can flip this horizontally. So we're going to flip horizontally. This is going to reverse the audio. I'm not sure why it's overlapping, though. And I'm going to take off the preserve start times. Okay. And accept it. So now we see it in reverse. and we're going to use that as a reference. So I'm going to mute these notes so they don't play. You know they're not playing, okay? So you got to check if they're playing, because sometimes you might not pull the velocity all the way down. So anyway, once you have that open, you can go to your piano roll options, go to helpers, activate ghost channels, okay? And that will show these as grayed out notes. So now when I go into my piano roll for the 808, you see these grayed out notes in the background. So that will help you go through musically what needs to happen with your 808. These are notes you can use to guide you through. Okay, so if you ever get confused, you can do that technique. Let's just go by ear. And what I need to do here is turn down the 808. So with the 808, you can't really tell its tone, okay, because it's so low, we're really not hearing its tone. See, that sounded proper in the lower octave, but it's completely wrong if we pull up the octave here. So figure out, what I like to do, again, is transpose the notes for the 808 so we can hear the tone, then I drop it down into the lower octaves. The secret we're going to do here is to create slide notes to make it feel like it's a real bass guitar. So I'm going to slide and do legato bends to really make this feel like it's a live instrument. So let's go to 808. First thing I need to do is give this an envelope. Let's turn the hold parameter all the way up. Let's go to the wrench tool and let's turn on portamento and monophonic mode, so it allows me to pitch bend between notes when they overlap. Okay. So now I'm going to create different pitch slides. And again, you want to think of it, since we added that hold parameter, the 808 only plays for the amount of the note length. So if the notes are short, it will only play for that amount of time. Now I'm going to go down, boom. I went to it's a pitch bend again. Do a lot of note bending, so we're going to use a lot of notes before notes and slide them up. Now the portamento, you want to be careful here, because if you have portamento on, it means it will pitch bend every single note, so you got to be careful with that. So I'm only going to put it on mono. I'm treating the bass line almost like it's a melody. Now I'm just trying to get the time right. Again, remember the note length plays a role in how long the 808 will trigger. So let's hit Control A, Control Down to bring these down into 808 range. So this is a little too much going on. So what I might do is actually space these out. So that's our core idea. That's fine. We can hit Control C, pull this into pattern 3, hit Control V, and I'm just going to get rid of the notes which are making it sound cluttered. But again, we're going to leave these pitch bend areas. So I like this pitch bend here. It sounds nice. this up to F. I'm going to extend that G note. Now, since we transposed it down an octave, it's acting as if it were a bass note now. So a lot of the harmonic structures, it's creating tension because there are certain notes which are clashing with this bass note of the pad. So that's why you really have to know music theory to kind of work your way around this. Also, you can EQ out the bass of the pad. So that's one solution you can use as well. So let's EQ out some of that sub bass in the pad. So I wanted to go da-na-na. So I'm going to copy this over here. Now I wanted to go da-na-na. So let's pull this up an octave so I can actually hear what's going on. And here's the pitch bend stuff I'm talking about, like live guitars. And we're going to do that for the 808. So it's a really cool, unique sound. I don't know why I said sound like that. Sound. We might even lower this down another octave. But it's very subtonal and you can barely hear the tone. Volume of the 808 does not need to overwhelm the track. We just need it as sub support. Pull it down just below the pad. So now let's get into drums. So now we have two parts of the song done. And one more thing I want to add is a pitch bend at the end here. So let's edit that pattern and I'm going to treat it like it were a live guitar. Like I said, let's find the MIDI. Say control A, control up just for now. And I want this to go from F to F, so an octave jump here. So I'm going to go from F, I'm going to hit control down, and what I'm going to do here is create, double click on it, and create a slide note, and make the F up top overlap that slide note. So we'll slide from this octave F to that F. And also make sure it starts off without overlap. So it creates ding, down, and it goes down. Okay, so that's a really unique thing you can use as well. But again, when you get into these lower octaves, it sounds like it's silenced because it's so low of a frequency we can't hear it. So figure out which octave works best for you. Let's open up our browser. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's load up the X drums. Let's find a nice kick. We just want a kick that's nice and punchy, but not overwhelming. A nice one. Let's load up a snare. Let's grab some hi-hats. That's all we need right now. Now the 808 pattern might be a little off. We can fix it later. Let's grab the kick. And again, we're going to space out our drums. Just like the bass notes are very spaced out. So again, we're producing in double time. That means we're going to use the snare on the 3 and the 7 instead of the 2 and the 4. And it creates the illusion that we're producing at a slower BPM. If we were producing at 100 BPM, it would sound like this. But we're not. Okay, so it's... And again, we do this to create easier hi-hat rolls and different benefits of having a higher BPM. Add the hi-hats. So we're gonna go t-t-t-t-t-t. Then we're gonna add hi-hat rolls. So instead of going t-t-t-t-t, you know, all the way through, let's create hi-hat rolls. We have a video on how to create hi-hat rolls and snare rolls for free on our YouTube channel. So let's right click, go to piano roll. And I want to roll this note here, so let's drag it out. This is one of the reasons we use higher BPMs. It's easier to create micro slicing. Let's go to half step, let's hit Control U. I'm gonna do that over here as well. And you can go on and on about hi-hats. I'm not gonna spend a great deal of time on that because we have videos going in depth on that. Make this unique so the drums change up over time. Let's change this to pattern 5 and let's add an extra kick in there. For a little extra impact, I would like to open up a cymbal for the downbeat to make the kick feel like it's hitting a little harder on the downbeats. To add this to a new pattern, I'm going to turn it down in the mix. And we're treating that 808 like it's a real bass. So let me turn off the monitor so you don't hear any extra bass in the microphone. Let's hear the pure song. Again, the next step would be to add the artist style over the track. So get in the mind of the artist and then record a vocal idea, like a hook or a verse, whatever you want to do. And then see if you can add more music on top of that. So that's how you take your song to the next level. You add your vocal idea, then you go back and see, can you take out things? Can you add things? And that's what gives you the next level of music production. If you want the darker sound, add that low pass filter back to the pad. So let's create somewhat of a structure here as if it were growing and building over time. Let's go to the filter. Let's right click, create automation clip for the frequency, and we can lower the frequency over time. So for the second half, I'm going to give it more of a dark tone by lowering that low pass filter. So it's going to be more muffled when you get into the second half. have it, the trap soul vibe, using three chord techniques. Again, you want to manipulate those pads to make them go in reverse. You want to give that 808 pitch bending qualities. And lastly, you want to space out your drums and produce in double tempo. So thanks for watching today. If you want to learn more about music theory for free, you can go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. We'll teach you all about chords, scales, everything you need to know to understand music theory quickly. So thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.